In this episode, I will build this model. Hi there! Here it is, the new Great Wall Hobby F14D Tomcat in 72 scale. The kit comes with 3 paint schemes and all of them are VF2 Bounty Hunters. That looks like I need to build the instruction book first. The instruction book is not well prepared and not designed smartly. That's why a huge correction page comes with the kit. Because of this, I will not trust the instructions and double check each step. Well, let's take a look at the sprues. Plastic quality of the kit is awesome. Surfaces of the parts are glossy, the details are well molded, and the panel lines are quite thin. It looks like an high quality Japanese scale model kit. However, the sprues are not marked properly. There are different size 7 sprues in the box which marked A. This isn't even the worst. The cockpit parts or the landing gear parts that should be combined in 1 or 2 sprue are separated to almost 10 different sprues. Despite the multi-piece and messy design, fitting of the kit is very well. You can build the wings with air brakes, slats and flaps, each one opened or closed. Here are a few examples to give you an idea of the kit's interesting but successful design. There are 2 options for the front landing gear strut. The landing gear parts look well detailed, however, they don't fit their places well. I realize now that's a good idea gluing them to their places before the paint. Let's start to paint with applying primer first. After that, I'm applying the cockpit color. I'm painting the details and the pilot figures with watercolor pencil and acrylic paints. And all the interior parts are ready for applying gloss varnish. By the way, I use a resin pilot and ejection seat set from Ares instead of the kit's seats. I'm applying weathering wash to all the painted parts. After applying flat varnish to all the painted parts, now I am painting to all glossy surfaces of the cockpit. Finally, the cockpit ready for gluing to its place. The canopy will be closed, so I'm gonna glue the windshield and the canopy to their places before masking them. Tamiya masking tape, a sharp number 11 blade and a good light source. These are enough for trouble-free masking. After fixing the noise part to the fuselage, finally some things look like an F-14. The missiles come with the kit very well detailed. I didn't notice any problems with them. Finally, the model is ready for painting. I'm painting the canopy parts with the interior color first. After that, I'm applying white primer to the model. Before applying the main color to the model, I'm masking red painted areas with PetaFix. Now I can apply the paint scheme to the model. And here we come to the most important stage of the build. This fading effect will provide the base for the weathering. The more detailed and finer the fading effect is, the better the entire weathering will be. As you can see, it's not white. A very pale hue of the main color. To get this result, now I'm painting random blue dots on the faded surface. To add more color depth, I'm painting random dots with dark gray. And finally, I'm applying the main color for filtering the all layers. The decals are excellent. I applied them without any problem. After the decals dry, I am applying gloss varnish with airbrush over them. After the varnish layer dry, I am applying the weathering wash to the panel lines. Then I am cleaning the excess wash using with a soft cloth. Before the final assembly and the weathering, I am applying flat varnish to the model. Now it's time to painting the exhaust parts. Finally, it's time to apply the final weathering with post shade technique. I use highly diluted paint mixture made with black and red brown for that. I know it's hard to follow on the screen what I'm doing right now. Simply, I'm painting the edge of shapes and the details with this mixture. I will try to simulate this on the model. This will give an idea about my post-shade weathering technique. Let's see the result. For completing the effect, I'm using a black extra soft pastel and old toothbrush. It's time to complete the model. I'm fixing the old parts to their places carefully. I'm applying some dust effect on the tires with extra soft pastel. The assembly of the landing gears were a nightmare. If you're gonna build this kit, glue them to their places at the first place. Some of the armaments are snap fit, some of them are neat to glue. Let's paint the navigation lights. I'm painting them with a silver marker first. After that, I'm painting them with clear acrylics. Also, I'm painting the windshield with clear green. Then I will apply a gloss coat over on it. So, the model is complete. Now, enjoy the pictures and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.